Hello friends, welcome to the official YouTube page of Everest IAS Academy. So today we are going to discuss March 23rd, 2020 Hindu newspaper analysis from the UPSC prelims 2020 point of view. So the first article which came in the headlines is Prime Minister thanks people for staying indoors, says battle not over. So basically friends, this article is coming in the backdrop of recent Janata curfew which was followed on March 22nd. So basically friends, as part of that actually, the recent novel coronavirus attack, because which was still not yet declared as an epidemic status in case of India. So as a preparatory stage only, we have already said that in our recent previous articles also, our country was actually like, we have prepared for that situation. So that was actually like done on a successful level. Even as part of that, after that, after an initiative which has been taken by the central government, now many of the states are themselves extending this, especially this section 144 like condition to all the parts of the states in the country. So basically this is happening on one part of the side, but what the Prime Minister has reassured the people is that, so basically friends, this is actually what he has said is that this is beginning of a long battle. In addition to that, what he has said is that the sirens are sounds which has been produced in this kind of actually like during this Janata curfew was considered as a victory in the long battle against the novel coronavirus. This was the official statement made by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So next article is the editorial article, The Perils of an All-Out Lockdown. So basically friends, this article is very very important for this year UPSC prelims as well as mains examination. So let's go and discuss this article too much in detail. So as we have discussed during our previous videos only, we have already said that this novel coronavirus attack, although it is recent, whatever we are feeling in the country is only upon the health front, but actually our country has to be prepared on a much more danger. So like economic tsunami which is going to happen in India with respect to the reduction in growth rate. So that is what where we have to be careful. We have already talked about this economic issues in which our country is actually going to face a next major actually problem in our country. So many experts have now started writing articles, especially by focusing upon the especially the economic issues of our country. So with respect to that only this article was all about, and in addition to that it also talk about the interlinkages between these two, economic and health crises. Because what happens is that during this health crisis, we already said that according to OECD status, the novel coronavirus or COVID attack will have a reduction of growth rate of 1 to 1.2% in the GDP of our country this year. So this is one like a report which has been published by the international organization itself. So basically it said very clearly the health effects, its impact, the impact of novel coronavirus health effect upon the economy of the country. But there is one more thing this particular author is talking about. Even this economic problem will also leads to some health crisis also in our country, because what he is highlighting is that at the current juncture, most of the public services of our government has been shut down, especially crucial among them were education. And then with respect to immunization program, now actually the program has been suspended in our country. So this is also will lead to especially the health like crisis in our country. So it is an interlinked twin relationship which he is talking about in this article. And he is also stressing upon the what are the areas in which government should go for providing income support and essential services. So let's go and discuss this article in detail. So basically friends, so what he is actually starting out with this is the interlinkages between this novel coronavirus and the economic crisis. In addition, the economic crisis is actually talking very much in detail, where especially the lower middle class, poor workers like migrant workers, street vendors, contract workers, and even those people who are employed in the informal sectors which will be hit by this economic tsunami is stemming as. So basically this is why this article is very important. In addition to that friends, so what this author is actually talking about is that our government should now actually like go for providing good social security system. Because what happened in other parts of the world is that many Western countries, notably Scandinavian countries and all, they have the world's best security model system in the world. But India is poorly placed upon that front, because India is having a more than 120 crore population in our country. So at this kind of population status, it's very difficult to go and provide social security net for all the peoples of the country. That's why our government is actually providing schemes which are actually targeted beneficial schemes like PDS schemes and then MNRGA workers which are available to all the rural areas of the country. So basically what this author is saying, at this point of juncture, the impact of novel coronavirus will be very huge on the lower strata and poor strata of the country. So we should go and provide this cash transfer benefit scheme. In addition to that, he is actually stressing upon the advanced payment for pension should be considered, and in case of PDS, more entitlements should be given, like rice and wheat they have to supply in large quantities, and even other essential goods also. And he is also talking about the immediate payment which the central government has to make to the state government with the arrears which they are having with respect to this NRGA wages. And he is also talking about the take home rations for schools and Anganwadis. So these are the things he actually is, the government should actually like consider doing this in the coming days. So in addition to that, friends, as we have already told, at this point of conjuncture, most of the essential services of the country has been hit. With respect to that, he is talking about public transport, administrative offices, court hearings. So basically, among these, the administrative offices and court hearings and even these MNRG wages, these kind of measures should continue in our country. That's what he is actually talking about. So he is also talking about that the kind of Janata curfew which was followed in our country on March 22nd, it is a kind of initiative which provides two motives for the people. One perspective is talking about a self-protection motive in which an individual will be safeguarded from the novel coronavirus. Second is a public purpose motive. So in public purpose motive, what he is talking about is that since actually we are participating in the collective efforts of the total people of the country, such that we are not giving an opportunity to for the virus to spread into a community chain like linkage. So basically this kind of initiatives has these two kinds of motives he is talking about. These kind of perspectives you can include in essays also, friends, while writing UPSC essay examination. If you include perspective like this, you will fetch more marks. So let's go and discuss other things also he is talking about. So what he is saying is that, so the essential services, now it has to be continued, because the essential services is including the public services, especially the administrative offices has to be opened now, because these are the offices which actually provides redressal grievance mechanism for the poor people of the country. So then he is actually talking about so the state government should also, there are some of the states in India like Kerala and all, they have officially come out with the list of essential services which they are going to provide, but at the union level our central government should also give you a guidelines that what are the things in which the essential services will be available, so that a clarity can be given to the people. So basically this is what is actually concluding about. So the government should immediately now open up on the crucial public services in our country. Then he is actually more stressing upon a cash transfer scheme, and the final thing actually is stressing about the economic, especially the whatever growth rate, GDP rate the country has to suffer, it has to be taken care of. So these are the three things which he is concluding in this particular article, friends. Next article is speaking of the quantum technology baton. So basically, friends, article like this kind of articles are very important for the science and technology column in UPSC prelims and mains examination. Basically, quantum technology is one of the recent technologies in the world in which actually major part of the world, if you see, friends, they are actually taking a leap in that. So they have been doing research in this particular technology only for the last 20 years, but India has started doing it only last 4-5 years on a very crucial level, and that too this year only, friends. In our union budget only, we have talked about our like finance minister, she has stressed upon the quantum technology. This particular mission will be promoted in our country. So that's why in that background only this article was written up. So basically, friends, the quantum technology as a concept, theoretically if you see, it's actually a much more complicated technology which various physicists actually across the world, they are doing research about. But let's go and understand this concept from a practical perspective. So basically, friends, if you see, normally when we use your mobile phone, okay, friends, in that actually like our battery, when we charge it, we can use it for maximum 24 to on an average 36 hours. So this is actually the normal storage of a battery. But when we use a quantum technology in this mobile phone battery, means this particular battery's lifetime can be extended up to 10 years. So this is the big advantage we have with the usage of various quantum technologies which are available in the world. So with that background only, this article is written, and in this article, this particular author is stressing upon how the government should take forward the quantum technology initiative in our country. In that perspective, actually he is talking about majorly in what of the fields actually like world countries are doing, in India we is actually lagging about. Then he is actually going and explaining the kind of initiatives which our in India we should do. Basically, he is telling that basically the problem which we face at the India is with respect to various science and technological domain is the kind of continuous support from funding from the government side is not assured. So this particular author is giving a solution saying that the government should go and involve both government as well as the private sector also while like providing the funding pattern for this developing this quantum technology. And one more thing is private industry should also be collaborated with, he is saying. So at this point of juncture we will be actually like having a continuous source of funding, and actually like even more funding can be collected. And once this funding is collected, means what this particular author is saying, there is a problem which we need to provide is actually we need a very good amount of theorists as well as a like experts, and these kind of experts are experimentalists we have to have. So basically theorist domain only, we have to collect various experts from the domain such that quantum technology and other practical applications from various physics field has to be interrelated and made into an practical commercial purposes. And once this technology is developed, means we have to have a collaboration with private industry also so that the particular quantum technology can be commercialized on a faster scale. This is the total crux of this particular article, friends. So let's go and discuss some additional points what he has stressed about. So he is actually giving a hint about in the recent budget, it talks very clearly about national mission on quantum technology and applications that we will discuss at the end of this article. So basically, friends, as we have discussed in the world now, what is the thing which is happening, means the quantum technology, when the quantum mechanics, when it's made its appearance, how it made it in the practical world, how it made a big difference is that with the application of usage of laser and semiconductor transistors. So basically this is where now most of the major applications has been. So this is where actually with the help of this influencing the quantum technology at the semiconductor level, the new kind of technology, that is a quantum computing, is evolving, in which actually a millions of calculations can be performed in seconds only. So this quantum computing technologies is also developed in the parallel, and even in our actually national mission on quantum technologies, we are having bigger stress on developing this particular technology. So let's go and see what are the other things he is talking about. So basically, friends, some of the advantages of quantum technologies is talking about, because what is happening is that we'll be creating a quantum materials. Second thing is then this application can be used in weather predicting models, because quantum technology when we use means the quantum computing can able to perform faster complex calculations in a millions of seconds or minutes. So in less than a minutes or seconds, we can produce such a huge amount of quantum of calculations, and this can be produced by the supercomputers or quantum computers which are created by this especially the quantum technology. So sir, one more thing is it is also going to provide a secured communication. With respect to that, only China has made a recent very leap in that particular field, because it is able to demonstrate there is a secured quantum communication which can be interlinked between terrestrial stations and satellites also. So for space communication only, we can go for secured mode of actually like transmission. That is what actually China has made use of using this quantum technology. So as we have said already, for developing this particular kind of quantum technology in India, we need a experiment mentalist and theorist across various fields like computer scientist, material scientist, engineers, physics. So this is where we should, when we have a funding, means we can invite the international experts to come and participate in India also for their research. So currently we are actually facing a problem with respect to resources and high quality manpower, so that we can invite from international level. Lack of funding can be solved from involving private sector also. So for private funding only, this author is stressing upon the philanthropic activity can also be promoted in case of India. So let's now go and discuss the National Mission on Quantum Technology and Applications, which was actually mentioned in this year budget also. So this is actually one of the 9 missions which was included as part of Prime Minister Science and Technology Innovation Advisory Council. So basically now let's go and discuss what this national mission is actually stressing upon. Means it is stressing upon 4 identical verticals they wanted to develop through this field in India. First, they are talking about quantum computing very clearly. Second is the development of quantum materials for that. Then quantum communications, that is a secured communications. Then fourth level is a quantum sensor and metrology. So in weather predicting model, we can use this quantum technology on a much larger scale. Next article is seizure of Afghan methane, HICE, triggers concern. So basically, friends, this article is very, very important in the, especially in the paper 3 of GS. That is, GS means paper 3. In security issues, these kind of articles will be picked very directly. Or sometimes they will ask even in GS paper 2 about this kind of, especially the drug trafficking and its impact in the Indian Ocean region or its freedom and its impact on India. So like these kind of questions can be asked as per the UPSC syllabus. So let's go and discuss this article in much detail, because here they are talking about a very different change which happened in the international drug carteling and trafficking. So this is the usual, this meth only is a new drug thing which they have actually captured, especially in the high waters of Sri Lanka, from the Sri Lankan coast in the high waters, deep inside the coast, deep inside the ocean. The Sri Lankan Navy, they actually caught some people who are actually carrying larger amount of heroin as well as a newly found material, that is the meth. So basically this meth is not very new to the other countries of the world, but the thing is, the kind of source which they have confirmed now is actually very news for the very good, totally new news for the total global world only, because this is this news is actually coming from the Golden Crescent region of the world. So basically, friends, there are two concepts in the world regarding drug carteling. One is a Golden Crescent, second is a Golden Triangle. So these are the two regions of the world which has a very much lead in, especially the drug carteling, that too especially heroines and opium production. So this is where actually like these two areas are very famous for. So this Golden Crescent region, it actually involves Pakistan, Afghanistan and then Iran. So these are the three countries. If you look in the map, means it will be coming like a crescent region, that continuity, all the three borders of the country. So it is actually named as Golden Crescent region, where opium actually is produced in larger scale and transported and smuggled to other countries. Second region they are talking about is a golden, especially that triangle region. So basically, friends, in case of Golden Triangle, this is actually covered in part of especially the Southeast Asian region. That is, they are actually talking about Laos, Myanmar, Thailand, Vietnam. So these four regions they are including as Golden Triangle region, so which is actually famous for opium production. So basically, till now these two areas are notable only for opium smuggling into other countries of the world. But recent change, what the Sri Lankan Navy was able to found, is that Afghanistan has made its change from selling from physical leaves and other things like drugs to other countries. From that, they have made a big change to laboratory and synthetic products. Especially this meth is a particularly, it's a chemical product which has to be manufactured in the lab. So there is a total change in the drug manufacturing in the country at the international arena. That too, it is coming from a Golden Crescent region. So let's go and discuss this article, friends. So basically, as we have discussed already, this recent raid out was done by Sri Lankan Navy successfully. At that time, they were able to seize 400 kg of heroin, which is not totally new to Sri Lankan Navy, because Afghanistan is very much famous for that. But actually, they were able to find newly this 100 kg of methamphetamine. So this is actually what we call it as meth shortly. So let's go and discuss this actually basics also in this article, friends. So one more thing is, as we have said already, this is actually appearing new, which is coming from an Afghanistan region. So as part of that, if you see Afghanistan, this meth is actually locally referred as siksha or glass. So with this, if you see the picture, means it will be very clear, friends. This is how it looks like. It looks like a glass. That's why in Afghanistan region it is called as siksha or glass. So basically what happened is that this is actually this siksha or glass, as or meth as we call, it made its appearance in Afghanistan in 2009 only, but on a very limited scale. That too in only grams only they were able to collect in Afghanistan region. So after that, some international organization, especially with respect to these drugs, it made its especially raid upon the particular area of Afghanistan. This was actually conducted during the time period of 2017 and 2018. So that time actually that UN International Mission on Drugs are actually able to control only the opium production. So after that, the opium production in Afghanistan, it came down on a larger scale. But what happened parallelly was the increase in meth production in the country. So this is a shift which happened at the international level. That's what they are discussing in this article also. And one more thing is regarding the meth production, how Afghanistan is able to produce in bulk, means this for the leaps for the meth base, actually it is a sherb they are collecting from a shrub which is called as Omanar ephedra. This grows very wild in the Afghanistan and mountains only, in Hemland, Ghazni and Wardak regions of Afghanistan. So these are the areas. So kindly remember these three places, friends. In UPSC, in map based column, especially every year 5 to 7 questions, that is 10 to 15 marks will come from Indian map and world map directly. In that, political places across the world and mountains, they will give in the match the following, which are frequently coming in Hindu like newspapers. So this is where the questions are picked from. So kindly remember, Helmand, Ghazni and Wardak belongs to Afghanistan regions. So basically, we will go and discuss the basics of this also. As we have discussed already, this there is a shift which happened from plant-based to chemical-based synthetic manufacturing of drug. That is the myth which was happening in the case of Afghanistan. That's what they are actually discussing. And one more thing regarding the chemical effects of this meptamine, that is meth. It is actually what will happen, means the persons who are consuming that, it will actually stimulate at the central nervous system. So brain will get stimulated, and it is used as a recreational drug by the youngsters. So one more thing is, it has a very high addiction system when we compare to the heroin which are currently available in the country. So basically, friends, this heroin is in across the world this heroin is found, but this heroin is actually considered to be not that much addictive as we compare to meth. So that is why it is considered to be very much dangerous phenomenon which is happening now. So, and one more thing is, friends, it will actually like medically it is currently used also in the medical arena as hyperactivity disorder and for solving obesity problem. So it is actually considered to be a toxin only. So basically this toxin will affect the brain functioning, and it is actually used as recreational purposes. So next article is, demand for cash transfers increases. So basically, as we have discussed already, due to the recent novel coronavirus attack, there has been a demand which has been coming from across the spectrum of the country, and the recent one is coming from Unorganized Workers Congress. They are demanding at least to provide each and every person 10,000 for cash transfer per month. So let's actually, we have to wait this for this from the government side, what they are actually going to come out with. Isolation is best weapon. This statement has been made by ICMR only. So we have already discussed about this. Stages of novel coronavirus spreading. First stage is at the imported cases level. Second stage is at the individual level. Third stage is at the community level. And the final stage only will be declaring it as an epidemic. And this status has to be done by ICMR only. So currently we are not in the stage of community transmission. That's why the next 14 days is going to be very crucial. That's why in various parts of the country, in India especially, we are going for section 144, and they are actually going for total shutdown in the country. Few major cities of the India have been shut down now. So and now regarding that, some of the updates which has been done by ICMR, what they are saying is that now they are actually going to test, they are currently testing 5,000 samples only, but they have increased their laboratory capacity to 50,000 to 70,000 tests a week. And one more thing is, our ICMR has assured the people of the country that they are actually already having the personal safety protective equipments for protecting the people who are from the, especially the poor and disadvantaged category. Next article is, can China's model work for the West? So basically, this article we have already discussed in our previous videos only. We have told already that what the model which was followed in China is the top bottom model, and this can never work for other countries, because what China have done, because their policy is communist policy. And one more thing is, they are actually driven by a centrally controlled top down one party authoritarian country. So basically, at that time there is no space for democracy, and no equality and liberty and privacy will be assured to the people, and doing everything at a military rule, and which is incomparable to for other countries of the world. So but what experts across the world they are saying is that Chinese model is actually successful in controlling the epidemic. But one thing we have to understand, what are the things they have done during this, especially this using the top down model. So basically what they did is that they have actually made sure that the Chinese people live in closed residential complexes only, and their movement in and around will be actually monitored by the neighboring committee only. They can police them also. Second thing is, they made sure that everybody is using that N95 mask, that safety mask they have to compulsorily wear, and China only went for producing lot of mask only in the country during that time period. So, and one more thing is, what this particular author is saying, in the Chinese citizens, their citizens' data is linked to a QR code, and this QR code will have a locational history also, because that citizens of China, they enjoy less privacy only, and this QR code using their phone only they can scan, such that they will be rated as green, yellow or red. Red means which was considered to be dangerous, and they entered some high risk zone during their recent some locational visits. So by this kind of models only, China was able to successfully control now. Thank you, friends. If you like our video, kindly subscribe to our channel, and if you have any doubts, please post your doubts in the comment section.